Hello, I'm Dr. Craig Idso, Chairman of the Center for the Study of Carbon Dioxide and Global Change. In recent years, governments and elected officials at all levels have proposed or enacted regulations and laws designed to restrict the use of fossil fuels via tax, caps, or fiat limits on CO2 emissions. Such efforts are based upon the notion that CO2 emissions are polluting the atmosphere and causing dangerous global warming. However, nothing could be further from the truth. CO2 emissions and fossil fuel use have actually enhanced life and improved the standard of living, and will continue to do so as more fossil fuels are used. Nevertheless, forces opposing fossil fuel use have grown in both number and political power. Their efforts enabled President Obama's EPA to declare in late 2009 that CO2 emissions resulting from the combustion of carbon-based fossil fuels are a current threat to human health and welfare. This so-called endangerment finding, however, was not the result of rigorous scientific study and debate. EPA relied too heavily on flawed computer model projections of possible harms that might occur in the distant future. And in the process, they chose to ignore real-world observations that invalidated the conclusions reached from computer model projections. The EPA also failed to analyze and account for critical and very significant direct and indirect benefits to both humanity and the natural world that result from CO2 emissions and fossil energy use in reaching their endangerment finding, benefits of which, if included, would likely have reversed their decision. We intend to bring these important facts to light in a new video series so as to build public support and political will to reverse the 2009 endangerment finding and other federal, state, or local established or emerging policies aimed at eliminating CO2 emissions and fossil fuel use. The title we have chosen for the series is The Greening of Planet Earth Confirmed. The new videos represent an addition and update to two prior works, The Greening of Planet Earth and The Greening of Planet Earth Continues, which were inspired and based upon two books, Carbon Dioxide Friend or Foe and Carbon Dioxide Earth in Transition, that were authored by our organization's president in the 1980s. These seminal works examine the role that CO2 plays as one of nature's basic building blocks of life in the process of photosynthesis and the evolution of the Earth's biosphere. In the first video, evidence was presented to show how CO2 levels in the atmosphere, which at the time of the film were about 30% higher than in the pre-industrial era, had greatly enhanced the growth of trees and other plants. Results from controlled studies were further cited to predict how a doubling of CO2 in the atmosphere, which is expected to occur before the end of the present century, would increase crop yields, improve water use efficiency of most of the Earth's vegetation, and greatly enhance the productivity of forests. By the time of the second video, the controversy over the effects of increasing levels of carbon dioxide on nature and the fossil fuel combustion that contributes to it had continued to intensify. Despite solid evidence to the contrary, many were speculating that increasing CO2 levels would result in apocalyptic global warming and eventual environmental disaster. In The Greening of Planet Earth Continues, expert scientists asserted otherwise. CO2 is not a pollutant, but a nutrient to life on Earth that provides a multitude of benefits to humanity and the natural world. The video also explored other key facts about climate history and the problems with computer model simulations used to predict the impact of increasing CO2 levels on future climate. And it presented a vision for the future that was in stark contrast to the alarmist forecasts of climate catastrophe that permeated the day. Nearly 30 years have passed since the first greening video was produced, allowing more than enough time to properly evaluate the accuracy of the two opposing viewpoints surrounding the potential human and environmental impacts of rising CO2 and fossil fuel use. In our Greening of Planet Earth Confirmed video series, we offer just such an assessment, demonstrating that there is absolutely no observational evidence that provides any compelling support for the contention that there is something unusual, unnatural, or unprecedented about Earth's current warmth. there is no real-world data confirming that floods, droughts, wildfires, hurricanes, or other extreme weather events are becoming either more frequent or more severe as a result of global warming. There is no indication that the total mass of Earth's polar ice sheets is on the verge of declining any faster than the proverbial snail's pace at which it has done so in the recent past. There is no evidence that sea levels are about to rise precipitously and inundate the world's coastal lowlands. Likewise, evidence is lacking in support of claims that searing heat waves are killing the poor and elderly and drying up precious farmland, that devastating diseases are spreading to regions previously considered immune to them, that migrating plants and animals will be unable to move to cooler locations fast enough to avoid extinction, that coral reefs will dissolve into oblivion as the oceans warm and turn acidic, or that anarchy will spread within and among nations as fighting erupts over dwindling water and food supplies. Additionally, our evaluation of existing data confirmed that it is undeniable that fossil energy initiated and continues to sustain the Industrial Revolution and the many human and environmental benefits that have emerged therefrom. Without adequate supplies of low-cost centralized energy, few, if any, of the major technological and innovative advancements of the past two centuries that have spurred economic growth, reduced poverty, increased literacy, and enhanced and prolonged human life could have occurred. Without the increased CO2 emissions from fossil fuel use over the past two centuries, Earth's terrestrial biosphere would be nowhere near as vigorous or productive as it is today. Rather, it would be devoid of the growth-enhancing, water-saving, and stress-alleviating benefits it has reaped in managed and unmanaged ecosystems from rising levels of atmospheric CO2 since the Industrial Revolution began. When considering and accounting for these and other positive improvements to humanity and the natural world, in conjunction with the absence of evidence of an impending climate catastrophe, it becomes scientifically and morally indefensible to demonize fossil fuel use and declare CO2 emissions a current or long-term threat to human health and welfare. The forces opposing CO2 emissions and fossil fuel use continue to grow in both number and political power. Our Greening of Planet Earth confirmed video series provides the antidote to their nonsensical policy proposals. It provides a clear and powerful evaluation of the two opposing hypotheses predicting the impacts of rising CO2 and fossil fuel use on humanity and the natural world, which evaluation is sorely needed and warranted. The reality is that our world needs more, not less CO2 emissions and fossil fuel use to enhance the future human environment. I hope that you will join with us in our efforts to bring these critical facts to light and provide an impetus for building public support and political will to reverse the 2009 endangerment finding and other state or municipal level policies aimed at eliminating fossil fuel use. We need your help and your financial support. Thank you, and stay tuned for more to come.